last time we looked at inquiry layout. Today we're going to look at how to modify inquiries. Let's take a look. I'm in accounts payable. I'm going to go to inquiry, invoice inquiries, and I'm going to take a look at the invoice register. I'm going to select my files. One of the most powerful things that you can do with inquiries is adding or modifying column information that you need to look at. These inquiries are built with just a few pieces of data for this given record. This record here that we're looking at is the vendor record. And we've got some information like the vendor number, the name, amount open, discount, year-to-date purchases, year-to-date paid. I'm going to drill down. Last time we talked about how to drill down by using the arrows here, drill down to more detail. I'm going to take a look at this vendor here, and I'm going to drill down to the invoice level. At any level, you can modify the columns. How do I do that? There's two ways to modify columns. One is to click on the column heading, and the other one is to click on this icon right here. If I hover over it, it says select. I'm going to just click right here, and now a box pops open. The column is highlighted, and I've got this option that says column options, and I've got four options. I can edit this column, I can add a column after, I can insert a column before, or I can even delete this column. I'm going to go ahead and add a column after this column. What I want to add is maybe some information like the accounting date. As soon as you click OK there, it's going to take you to the record where this inquiry was written. In this case, it's the invoice record. Now, I do have capabilities of indexing to other records or formulas, but I'm going to go ahead and just add the accounting date from this record. So I'm going to go down and find the accounting date. Right there it is. And I'm going to select that, and it's going to default the upper heading and the lower heading and the width. Now you can change that, these headings, if you want to call it something else, you can change these. But if I'm good with that, I'm just going to say okay. Now I've got that column right there in my inquiry. So this is very useful when you're looking at data and there's additional data you want to see on the screen. You can also filter data. So what is a filter? A filter is a way to see less data. Maybe we want to do it by date. Maybe we only want to see invoices for the current year, or maybe we only want to see open invoices. The way you put filters or Sage calls conditions is to hover over this right here, this icon, the filter, and it says conditions. If I click on that, now I can add a condition. Now I want to go grab, and I just want to grab the invoices that are open. So there's a field called status, and I'm going to highlight that, and I'm going to select equal to, and then I'm going to select the value open. So now that's only going to give me a list of open invoices. So you can see my list is shorter now that I put a filter on there. You can also put multiple filters by clicking on the add button, and you can set up additional filters. Maybe we only want to see invoices that are over a certain dollar amount. So I'm going to say and the amount is greater than, maybe I only want to see invoices that are greater than $1,000. So now I'm seeing even less information because I've got that second filter or condition. Another one of the powerful tools within inquiries is the ability to extract the data. We've got a couple options there. We can extract it by printing it. And I can print it by hovering over here, this icon, the little printer, and hit that. And I'm just going to print preview. We could hit it, print it to the printer, or we wanted to, we could print it to a file simply by going into the printer setup and selecting print to file. I'm just going to print preview. So what Sage does is any column that is an amount field, it automatically adds a total. So this is a quick, easy way to get a report out and have the system put totals on that report. Now I could print that out. The other option is to export the data to Excel. Now you'll have an icon here that has, looks like Excel. If I hover over that, it'll say export to Excel. And what it's going to do is the columns that I added or any filters that I put on, so basically what I see on the screen, it's going to take that and export that data to Excel simply when I click on this icon. So now here's the Excel document. It dumped that data straight into Excel, all those columns of information. Now, once I have it in Excel, then I can take the features of Excel and I can sort, I can put filters, whatever I want to do. I can even save this file by doing a save as. Now, keep in mind that Sage will create this Excel file in your database. So periodically, you may want to go clean up those files that Sage creates. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for the next video in the series, Inquiries and Inquiry Designer, Part 3, Saving Changes to Inquiries with Inquiry Designer.